You have learned how to use Lyapunov's direct method to prove stability and local or global asymptotic stability of an equilibrium point. We also have a Lyapunov theorem for exponential stability. We still consider the same system as before, a system described by a time-invariant ordinary differential equation, where the function f is defined on some domain D in the state space, which contains the origin, which is the equilibrium point of interest. Theorem 410 says that if there exists a Lyapunov function candidate defined on D, and there exist positive constants A, K1, K2, and K3, such that the following conditions are satisfied. V is continuously differentiable. V is larger than or equal to the constant K1 times the norm of X raised to the constant A. The norm used in this theorem can be any of the P norms on the vector state space, but we usually use the Euclidean norm. And V is smaller than or equal to the constant K2 times the norm of X raised to the same constant A for all X in the domain D. These two conditions only concern the function V itself. And then comes the third condition, which is where the system equation comes into play. The time derivative of V should be less than or equal to the negative of the constant K3 times the norm of X raised to the same constant A. And also this should be satisfied in the domain D. Note that, as in previous examples, the choice of domain D does not only depend on whether the system vector function is well defined here, but we may also choose to further restrict the domain D to a smaller domain where conditions 2 and 3 are satisfied. If all three conditions are satisfied for some domain D about the origin, then theorem 410 gives that the origin is exponentially stable. This theorem is known as the Babashin-Krasovsky theorem, but for simplicity, we will just call it the Lyapunov theorem for exponential stability, since it is a theorem using Lyapunov functions to prove exponential stability. Also note that I have rewritten theorem 410 for time-invariant systems, which is what we consider for the time being, but theorem 410 in the book actually holds for time-varying systems, which we will get back to. When using this theorem, note that you must of course use the same norm in all the three inequalities, and that it should be the same power, the same constant A, in all the three inequalities. You may also note that the conditions are stricter than in the Lyapunov theorem for asymptotic stability, which makes sense since exponential stability implies asymptotic stability. So it's a stronger property. Specifically, you can see that this inequality here implies that V is a positive definite function in D, and that this condition here implies that the derivative of V is negative definite in D. If the conditions in the theorem are satisfied in the whole state space, then the origin is globally exponentially stable. So, why do we not need to include radial unboundedness as an additional requirement for global exponential stability, like we had to do for global asymptotic stability? It is because the second condition implies radial unboundedness. Specifically, have a look at this inequality here. What happens if the norm of X goes to infinity? Then the left-hand side here goes to infinity. And since condition 2 requires V to be larger than or equal to this, this implies that also V has to go to infinity. It can be shown that when the system satisfies the conditions of the Lyapunov theorem for exponential stability, then the norm of the solution x of time t is less than or equal to this constant times the norm of the initial state times this exponentially decaying function. So we have a measure of the convergence rate. Let us consider an example. Pause the video and show that the origin is a globally exponentially stable equilibrium point of the system. First, let us show that the origin is indeed an equilibrium point of the system. To find the equilibrium points of a system that are in this general state space form here, we set f of x equal to 0 and we solve for x. Here f of x is minus x raised to 3. So we set this to 0 and we solve for x. This is the same as minus x times 1 plus x squared equals 0. And we see that this only has one real solution, x equals 0. So the system only has one equilibrium point, and this is at the origin. Now let us use Lyapunov's direct method to analyze the stability properties of this equilibrium point. First, we choose a Lyapunov function candidate. We start with the simple choice, which is the quadratic function, v of x equals 1/2 times x squared, which is 1/2 times the Euclidean norm of x squared. Then we determine whether this candidate function really is a Lyapunov function, or preferably a strict Lyapunov function for the equilibrium point, by checking whether it satisfies the condition of Lyapunov stability theorem, theorem 4.1, and possibly also theorem 4.2, giving global results. And if we find that this is a strict Lyapunov function, which implies that the equilibrium point is asymptotically stable, we investigate whether the Lyapunov function candidate also satisfies the stronger conditions of theorem 4.10 that allow us to show the even stronger stability property of exponential stability. So that is our game plan. The first condition is that V is continuously differentiable, which it clearly is, since it is a polynomial. The second condition of Lyapunov's stability theorem is that the function is positive definite, meaning that v of 0 is 0, and that v is strictly positive for all x that are non-zero in some domain D. Clearly, 1/2 times x squared is 0 when x is 0, and it is strictly positive for all non-zero values of x. So our Lyapunov function candidate is positive definite in the whole state space. The third condition of Lyapunov's stability theorem is that the derivative of v is negative semi-definite, or preferably negative definite. Let's see if it's negative definite, meaning that the derivative of v is 0 at 0, and the derivative of v is strictly negative for all x in some domain D, except at the origin. To evaluate this, we must find the derivative of v. So the time derivative of v is the derivative of v with respect to x, which is x, times the time derivative of x, according to the chain rule. And then we'll look at the system equation again. This gives x dot. So this is minus x squared minus x raised to 4, which is only 0 when x is 0 and strictly negative everywhere else. So v dot is negative definite in the whole state space. So our Lyapunov function candidate satisfies the conditions for being a strict Lyapunov function in the whole state space. And by Lyapunov's stability theorem, we then know that the origin is asymptotically stable. Is it also globally asymptotically stable? We have to check whether our Lyapunov function is radially unbounded. Remember that v of x is 1/2 times the norm of x squared. So if the norm of x goes to infinity, then also the function v, which is proportional with the norm squared, goes to infinity. So v is radially unbounded. And then by theorem 4.2, the origin is globally asymptotically stable. Can we show the even stronger stability property of exponential stability? Then we have to check whether our Lyapunov function also satisfies the conditions of theorem 4.10. The first condition of v being continuously differentiable we have already established. So how about the second condition? Well, v of x equals 1/2 times the norm of x squared. So the second condition of theorem 4.10 is satisfied with a being 2 and k1 is equal to k2 is equal to 1/2. We could also have chosen other values for k1 and k2, for instance k1 being 0.1 and k2 being 10. But if you remember the bound on the solution giving the convergence rate, we want k1 as large as possible and k2 as small as possible to give as tight a bound as possible and as high a convergence rate as possible. How about the third condition? We have shown that the derivative of v equals minus x squared minus x raised to 4. Can we find a constant k3 such that this is less than or equal to minus k3 times the Euclidean norm of x squared? And remember that the constant a must be the same in conditions 2 and 3, so a equals 2 is given. Well, this is the same as minus the Euclidean norm of x squared minus the Euclidean norm of x raised to 4. We need a to be 2, so this term here is of no use to us. But it has the important property that it is always less than or equal to 0, which means that the derivative of v is always less than or equal to minus the norm of x squared, which means that the third condition of theorem 4.10 is satisfied with k3 equal to 1. And all the conditions are satisfied in the whole state space. So by theorem 4.10, the origin is globally exponentially stable. And we have an upper bound on the solution of x. The norm of x of t is less than or equal to k2 over k1 is 1 times the norm of the initial value times the exponential function e raised to minus 1 over 1, so raised to minus t. So, to sum up all you have learned about Lyapunov's direct method, the way to apply it is that you first choose a Lyapunov function candidate. Then you determine whether this candidate satisfies the conditions of any of the Lyapunov theorems, the Lyapunov stability theorem 4.1, the global Lyapunov stability theorem 4.2, or the Lyapunov theorem for exponential stability theorem 4.10. If the answer is yes, then you have proven a certain stability property for the equilibrium point in question. Stability, asymptotic stability, or exponential stability, and either local or global for the two latter. If the answer is no, and you have not been able to prove as strong a stability property as you think the equilibrium point really has, then you start over with another Lyapunov function candidate.